Y'all ready?
Yes.
Me too. Okay, let's take child's pose, pose of the child. And however you practice here is right here. You take this pose right here. It's perfect. Do it the way you want, the way you're called to do it, however you do it. Do it. Be it. Bring breath, ujjayi, breathing, deep and free, ujjayi. And you've journeyed here, and you've taken something for you to be here. Everything that's led up to this moment, and your first pose here at level one, all it took something for you to get here. And being here, you're excited to be here, you're scared to be here, you're nervous about being here, or you're inspired about it. Whatever's here, just let it all be here. And let be about this breath, this moment, right here. Land here. All the expectations, yeah, all it took to get yourself, all the planning, all that. Let all that just go and get yourself right here, this pose, this moment, this floor, and then come to downward facing dog. Feel it out, walk it out. You could walk your hands and feet further away from each other, front to back. Go long in your stance, move left, right, however you want to move. Whatever seems to be calling you, bend a knee here or over there, or get grounded more powerfully through your hands into your knuckles. You can shake your head around, yes and no, let your jaw go. And then come into stability. Sthira Sukha Asanam. Steady, stability, and free. Breathing deep and free, moving breath, ujjayi, being the experience of victory in this breath. If I don't have anything else in my life right now or whatever is going on, I've got this breath right here, this breath. From this breath to your body, from your body, center to extremities, hands and feet to the floor, root deeper, take your hips higher, and then walk your hands to your feet, uttanasana. Walk your hands to your other feet, some of you, the feet at the back of your mat. Mm-hmm. And then move side to side, sway, feel it out. Yeah, really feeling, getting in touch with your body. So the three themes of this Baptiste Yoga training, the three themes you'll be working with this week are be a yes, give up what you must, and come from this is it, this moment. This moment is all I've got. If I'm going to make a difference, if I'm going to have some kind of shift, this is the moment in which to dance with. And you're dancing an asana with your body, tangible. You're going to dance with your energy contained in your body. You're in a dance with all the life experiences that you've walked into the door with this evening, everything you brought with you. Yeah, all the world that you brought with you. Stress, whatever's here for you. Fear, stiffness. A lot of you look stiff. That you walked into the door with that. Mm-hmm. All the stress and then eating the stress. What is stressed spelled backwards? Yeah, dessert, exactly. Stress doesn't make you feel like eating lettuce. Just saying. Okay, downward facing dog. Yeah, so all of it, whatever you've walked into the room with, whatever you're bringing to the mat right here, be in a dance with all of it. Be a yes for some kind of opening. And it isn't to make anything bad or wrong or shouldn't be. No, whatever it is, allow for it, a total acceptance of all of it. And though you're in a dance with some kind of shift, some kind of union with some kind of higher quality of experience. Okay, walk your hands to your feet. Downward dog. High plank. Low plank. High plank. Downward dog. Walk your hands to your feet, Uttanasana. Bend your knees. Bring your belly into your thighs. Bend your knees and make the connection of your abdomen to your thighs, your torso to your thighs, like that. Then interlock your fingers at your lower back. Keeping your elbows bent here. Pin your shoulders into your back, then wrap your arms forward over your head. Zip up your legs, zip them up, straighten. Bring your hips forward toward your toes a bit. Wrap your arms forward even more. Bring your hands to the floor. Walk your hands forward, downward facing dog. High plank. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, Chaturanga Dandasana. High plank. Downward facing dog. Walk your hands to your feet. Bend your knees. Torso to your thighs. Interlock your hands at your lower back. And plug your shoulders into your back. Wrap your arms forward. And from your feet, ground down, plug your heels down and zip up your thighs. Firm up your thighs into the bones, your hamstrings moving to the heavens, straightening your legs more. Wrap your arms forward a little more. Work from the floor to core, core to the floor. From the floor, pull up earth power, earth energy, right up into the core, the earth of your body. From earth, bring flow. Water flows through earth, or is held through earth, but the quality of water, fluid. Okay, downward facing dog. In balance with earth, Sthita Sukha Asanam. Take a deep breath out, empty. Zip up the pit of your belly toward your spine. Step up to the top of your mat. Please lift halfway up, inhale. Exhale, yogi bow. Root down and rise up. Arms alongside your body, samasthitihi. Eyes to one point. Relax your eyes, drishti, Anjali mudra. Hands to your heart center, and we'll take three ohms. Deep breath in. Up, reach up, inhale, bow forward, exhale, lift halfway up, inhale, come to high plank, low plank, exhale, upward facing dog, inhale. Downward facing dog, exhale. Set your eyes to one point. Ujjayi, deep and free. Be present here. Really get the drishti. See a physical point. See what you see. Really, you see what you see. And be, from what you see, be present to your body, the center of your body, to the extremities, the floor. Press through the floor and reaffirm up into the core of your body. Ujjayi. Ujjayi, the breath, opening your ears, listening. So you're looking, you're seeing what you see. You're in a listening to the breath. You're making breath, creating breath, generating breath flow. Inhalation is given by the full extension of exhalation. So you're in the practice here of the pillars, drishti, ujjayi, bandhas. Bandhas, the core, to extremities, to the floor. Drishti, see what you see. Ujjayi, the rhythm, the flow of moving breath through your body powerfully and in such a way that you're left in a new experience, new space. A deep breath out, yogi, empty, floor to core, sit your drishti forward, uddiyana bandha, pit of your belly toward your spine, and jump forward. Lift halfway up, inhale, yogi, bow, exhale. Root and rise, inhale. Bow, exhale. Halfway up, inhale. Vinyasa, so chaturanga, high to low plank. Up dog, downward facing dog. However you're doing the pose right now is perfect. Just perfect. Not here to dissect you this week, evaluate you, fix your poses. You'll have the opportunity this week to empower each pose. You'll have the opportunity to empower your practice in a whole new kind of way. And that'll be your work. We'll give you the principles. We'll give you the methodology. We'll give you the steps to, we'll give you like each rung to the ladder. That's our job. Your job is to take the step on to each rung. It should give you a methodology. But tonight, your work is like, oh, however I'm doing the practice is perfect. However the person next to me or people around me are doing the practice is perfect. I'm saying that to some of you, the know-it-all expert yoga teacher people in here who know how to do it right and think everyone else should be doing it right or they're going to hurt themselves, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, just how can you get to, oh, however I'm doing it right now, there's a reason your body's doing it the way it's doing it. And take a deep breath out, yogi empty, jump forward, good, halfway up, exhale, bow, root down and rise up, exhale, bow, halfway up, chaturanga vinyasa, upward dog, downward facing dog. So the three themes in action, in the asana, the three themes, be a yes. So that means you're really being for something in the pose. Being for something. Maybe it's just being totally accepting. I'm a yes for total acceptance of how the pose is, how it isn't. Accepting how I'm feeling, how I'm not feeling. Accepting all of it. Or, yeah, whatever you choose. Acceptance is an example. But whatever you're a yes for, let your actions, let each breath, each moment be a moving toward and opening into whatever it is you are a yes for. Give up what you must. And this moment is it. This is a moment you dance with, in a dance with, to have yes, what you're yes for, be real. A deep breath out, empty, yogi, empty. Jump or walk forward. Lift halfway up, inhale. Exhale, you bow. Root down, rise up, inhale. Bow forward, exhale. Halfway lift, inhale. And through your vinyasa, so chaturanga, low plank, up dog, down dog. Take a deep, deep breath out, empty. Look forward and jump. Bow. Bend your knees deep. Utkatasana, thunderbolt. Reach up. Exhale, bow. Halfway lift, inhale. Chaturanga, vinyasa. Up dog. Downward dog. Right leg steps forward. Back foot flat. Warrior one. Chaturanga. Upward dog. Downward dog. Left leg forward, warrior one. Chaturanga. Up dog. Down dog. Take a deep breath out, empty. Walk or jump forward. Halfway up. Exhale, bow. Bend your knees, reach up, Utkatasana, thunderbolt. Uttanasana, bow. Trini, halfway lift. Chaturanga Dandasana. Up dog. Down dog. Right leg steps, Virabhadrasana one. Chaturanga. Up dog. Down dog. Left leg, Virabhadrasana one. Chaturanga. Up dog, down dog. Take a deep, deep breath out. Jump forward. Bow. Utkatasana. Uttanasana, bow. Halfway lift through your vinyasa. Right leg steps, warrior one. Vinyasa, up dog, down dog, left leg, warrior one, vinyasa, down dog, yeah. Take a deep breath out, empty. Look forward and jump. Bow. bend your knees, reach up, bow, halfway up, through your vinyasa. Right leg Virabhadrasana, one, warrior one, reach, root to reach, chaturanga. Up dog, down dog. Left leg Virabhadrasana, one, vinyasa. Take a deep, deep breath in and a sigh. Again, a big breath in and a sigh. Take your heels to the sky. Lift your right leg up. Bend your upper leg. Lift your hip like a dancer and you'll flip your dog. Open your throat. Trishti. Uchayi. Extremity to core. Opening, expanding. Okay, come on up, side plank. So down dog, come to down dog and bring your feet together. Lift your heels over the balls of your feet. Spin your heels to the right, left arm to the sky. Vastistasana. It's kind of warm in here, yeah? Makes you want to drink water. Take your top leg to the sky. Take your upper foot over, roll over, upper foot to the back side of your mat this time. Go this way, play this way, free as can be, opening into new reality. Okay, come on up and chaturanga. Careful on your way, it's dangerous coming out of that. Right foot steps, crescent lunge. Anjaneyasana, back heel stays up. Yeah. Cross your thumbs. Plug your shoulders and your back. So lift your shoulders up, sides of the body, long, Uddiyana. Plug your shoulders into your back. Chin to your neck, open your throat, look up. So get firm at the feet to the floor, pull up to core. Pull the pit of your belly in, expanding up through your chest, your upper back, puffing your inner yes out. Go back, up and back. Look forward, hands to your heart center, and twist. Prayer twist. Take one hand, lower hand to the floor, to the outer inner side of the leg, upper arm to the sky. Look down, come up and around, back heel down, Vira 2, Virabhadrasana 2, Warrior 2. So you'll take full bind around the front leg. So you'll bring your right arm, lower arm, under the front leg. Take your upper arm, corkscrew it around your back. Catch your hands. Scoop your tailbone. Plug in through your feet to the floor. Pull up into core. Open your heart. Look up. Hips lower, a lot of you. Open your heart. Oh, just have fun. However you're doing it is great. It may not look great, but it's great. Own that. It may even look terrible, some of you. And it's perfect. It's just perfect. Really. It's called Doing the Practice. Oh, Chaturanga. Sorry, I forgot. Up dog, down dog. Notice I never forget in like child's pose or something. Bring your feet together. Lift your heels to the sky. Spin your heels to the left, right hand to the sky. Side plank, Vastisthasana. Yeah, let it all just be perfect. Nothing to fix, nothing to figure out. Forget what you've learned. If what you learned worked, you're doing it right now already. So do what you're doing. Be who you're being. Nothing to change. Be at ground zero. Otherwise, we're just piling on stuff. And then come on. Oh, top leg goes up. Don't forget that. Upper foot goes back behind you, over into the possibility on this side. A full expression in this side. The pose, the practice of yoga as I've learned it is not some place to get to in the pose. The work is, where am I coming from? Not where I'm getting to. Where am I coming from that is in service of what I'm a yes for? And express that out. Good. Come on up. Downward facing dog. You did side plank, yeah? Both sides, you're all even? All even, Steven? Okay. Extra flip dog? Okay, do flip dog on this side, left leg up. That's why I have you here, to remind me what comes next. Go ahead, other side over. If I was doing it by myself at home, it would go terrible. Get rights and lefts and... Some of you look like you're taking a gigantic bowel movement. Just saying. That's one angle on it. There's one way to do it. And there are options. And suffering is optional. Come on up. Nice. Vinyasa. Chaturanga Dandasana. Urdhva. Mukha Svanasana, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Getting here, getting present right here. Through Drishti Ujjayi, Bandhas, Tapas, Vinyasa. Take a deep breath out. Left leg steps forward, crescent lunge. Look around a bit. Look around like you're already doing, most of you, but pretending not to do. Yeah, just look around. Let the drishti wander. Let your third eye wander. Yeah, look around. Kind of get that out of your system. Whatever. Okay, lower is to look around. And then now just set your eyes to a point. Find a physical spot. Sometimes we need to allow ourselves the freedom to just be and kind of let it go. But now you zoom in, you focus in, drishti, you hone in to a physical point visually, and then notice you get access to the breath, to the core, from the center of the body out to the periphery, engaging from the outside in and from the inside out, matching up the inner you to the outer you, the outer you to the inner you. This is the union we call yoga, when the inner you is matching the outer expression of you, the outer actions in the world. It's a beauty of asana. Okay, twist. Bonus holding on the left side, because you seem weaker on this side. So do a little longer holding. Straighten your arms. The only goal in the pose is no goal. Get present to your experience. Get present to your drishti. See what you see. Ujjayi. There's nowhere to go. There's getting here, and then from here, opening into what's available in your expression, stretching out, reaching out, opening out, expanding, floor to core, core to floor, bigger, brighter, lighter, happier, always happy in the asana. Could be a goal. Warrior two, come up and around. Fear of Vajrasana two. What do you yes for? What do you need to give up right now that's in the way? What do you need to let go of that's in the way of you being who you want to be, who you're a yes for in this pose, in this moment, this breath? There's some mentally, some resistance, some thought, something. Can you let it go, and can you get your drishti right here? Your breath right here. Your core to extremity right here. Take your full bind. Parsva Konasana. Loving it, going into it. If you're newer to the practice, in a pose like this, and that's exciting. Like, wow, what an opportunity. It's boundless possibility for you in this pose, and to have a transformation in this pose is simply a demonstration of a transformation in your physical being, the physical culture of your body. Not forcing, but exploring in wonderment. What's possible in this pose here if you're new? If you're very experienced, been doing this forever, well, what's there to discover new for you? Holding like this allows for new discovery, certainly new learning about you. You get confronted by you. If you're in conflict in the pose, then you're in conflict with yourself. That's all. Get straight about it. If you're in conflict with it, that's some conflict with self. What do you need to resolve to be? Okay, vinyasa, chaturanga. We'll feel good after that, yeah? Suddenly we love chaturanga. Up dog, down dog. Have you ever heard the saying, if they can't see the light, make them feel the heat? Have you ever heard that saying? If they can't see the light, make them feel the heat. Well, in level one, we do both. We go for the light and the heat. It's called tapas. Tapasya. A moment-to-moment inaction discovery of your potential. The potencia of who you are. Okay, a long breath out. Yogi, empty. Let's flow now. Bring it to life. Jump forward. Halfway lift. Inhale. Exhale. Bow. Bend your knees deep. Utkatasana. Reach up. Hands to your heart center. Twist your left arm to the outer right thigh. Twisting. Utkatasana. Arm straightening. One hand down. One arm up. One, two, three, four. rinse more, bow forward, split your feet hip width, take your big toes with your peace fingers, lift halfway up, inhale, bow forward, exhale. Shake your head, yes, no, let your head drop. Drishti, see what you see. Open your ears, Ujjayi, listening to your breath. Release your feet, toe heel your feet together, bend your knees, Utkatasana, reach up, inhale, through your heart center, twist to the other side, straightening your arms, Utthita, spread through the bones and muscles of your chest, lengthening front to back, butt back, tailbone to the sky, lumbar spine to your belly, pull the pit of your belly, expand through your chest, more open, spin and bow. Split your feet hip width, gorilla asana, slide your palms under your feet, toes up to your wrists, halfway up, breathe in, exhale, bow. Truth is, this is so, so healthy. So healthy. An opportunity to cleanse, to open, to flush out the old, the past, physically, energetically, mentally. An opportunity to strengthen, to integrate, to connect, to get to know, to see into self newly, into me, I see. Release your feet from your hands and toe heel your feet together, yogi. Bend your knees, Utkatasana, thunderbolt. Breathe here. Lift your 10 toes. Pull your your fingers out of your hands. Take a deep breath out. On your inhalation, sit deep. And then breathe here, chest higher. Take a deep breath out. On your inhalation, sink deeper. Shins back, heart open. Again, take a deep breath out. On your inhalation, sit deeper, reach higher, sit deeper, 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 and then launch straight up. And samastitihi, yogi. See what you see. Eagle pose, breathe in. Take your arms up and breathe out. Right arm over, right arm under, right leg over. Right leg over, right arm under. Garuda asana. And samastitihi, tadasana, standing at attention. Breathe out. Eagle pose, other side. Left arm under, left leg over. Take a deep breath in. Samastitihi, standing at attention. Breathe out. Inhale. Eagle, other side. Right arm over, right arm under, right leg over. Samasthitihi. Breathe out. Inhale. Exhale. Eagle, other side. Left leg over, left arm under. Find your inhalation And sama sitihi, exhale. Catch your hips with your hands, thumbs to your sacrum, integration. Lift your right leg. Catch your right foot, the baby toe side of your right foot with your right hand. Breathe in, integration, pull on the core, periphery to core. Exhale, expand out. Take your leg to the right. Look over your left shoulder. If people are in the way, do what they do when I teach us in New York. They just push, kick them out of the way. Or if people are in the way, you could do it. They do when I teach us in California. They massage them. Massage their foot. Look forward. Point your toes straight, like catch your hips. Airplane. Dikasana. Hands to your heart center, pause. Half moon or bound half moon, choose, yogi's choice. Extending half moon or bound half moon. Keep it easy from drishti, ujjayi. Core to floor, all the limbs activating. Okay, downward flowing, uttanasana. Step your left leg back behind you. Bring your back knee down to the mat. Chest over your hips, catch your hips with your hands. Catch your back foot with your left hand. Pull it in or press it in, yoga mudra. Thumb to first finger, extend your upper arm high, look up and go back. So from your feet, through your legs, engage the muscles in and up in your core, pelvic floor lifting. Uddiyana, upper chest, upper back expanding. Downward facing dog. Look forward, take a deep breath out. And then you can walk up or jump up into crow. Crow. Ready, set, you go. Like that. One. Two. Three. Any kind of crow will do. Four. Feet flat to the mat. Walk your feet up to the top of your mat. Feet are together. Catch your hips with your hands. Breathe out. Root down. Straight spine. Stand up. Drishti to the horizon. Lift your left leg. Catch your left foot. From extremity to core, draw in center line and core. Breathe in. Breathe out. Extension. Expansion, being in a dance with inhalation, exhalation, the drishti, moment to moment, take your leg out, opening. If someone's in your way, you can do what they do when I teach this in Boston. They write a whole thesis about it. You could, someone's in your way, you could do what they do when I teach this in Canada. They say sorry. Take your leg forward. Straight leg. Point your toes. Catch your hips or whatever you want with your arms. Take your arms up. Breathe in. Take the leg up too. Airplane. Hands to your heart center, Anjali. extending half moon. So right hand down, left arm up, or bound half moon, chapasana. Choose it. Be a yes for this pose. Not for getting it right or something, but being in the full experience and nudging some kind of opening, integrating, opening, moving to some freedom, newfound freedom. Give up trying hard. And then good work. Come down. Step your right leg back behind you into lunge. Back knee down. You're doing great, everyone. May not look like that. And you're doing great. May not feel like that. And you're doing great. Take your arms up. And if it feels great, that's great. If it looks great to you and to no one else, that's great. Make it great, whatever it is you're doing here, make it great. Just let it be great. Perfect, unbroken, whole. Okay, catch your back foot with your back hand, your right hand, yeah? Let it right hand your right foot. Squeeze the leg in. Yoga mudra. Thumb to first finger. Good work. Downward facing dog. So you'll jump into a crow, or you could walk into crow. Ready, on your mark, get set. Yogi, fly. And any kind of crow, any kind of crow. Get both feet on the floor, both heels up, one foot on the floor, both feet off the floor. Choose it, create it, be it, fly high above it all. Good, set your feet flat on your mat, feet at the top of your mat, please. Do you all have a strap? Good. Take the strap. If you don't have a strap, you could use a towel, but you'll take the strap, stand up, not to Rajasana with the strap. So you'll take the strap around your right leg. You do right foot, right ankle, right instep, what have you. Not to Rajasana. Key here to get your shoulder integration. Pin your shoulders to your back. Go for it. One. Two. Three. Tongue in your mouth. Four. Five. Good. Good, good. Other side. Keep it easy as can be. Keep it real. Catch the left leg, yeah. Ready. Set. Drishti. Wait for me. And go. One, two, three, four, five. Other side. Ready. Drishti, take aim. Strap around the ankle. And yogi, you go. One. Breath. Two. Three, four, five. That feels so good. Oh, that's what I needed after a plane ride. Okay, other side. Catch your left leg, the strap, left foot, one, ready, set, go. Two. Three. Bring mastery. Practice this pose as a master would practice it. Consider you've got that as a possibility right here. Okay. Consider if you fall out of a pose, you could fall out as a master would fall out. Different than a rookie. Yogi, what do you call a rookie yogi? Gina? A rogie. That could be a good level one t-shirt. A neophyte. They call it, over in India, you're called a neophyte when you're new. You look hot. Careful, it's cold out there. Okay, Samasthitihi at the top of your mat. Vrikshasana, tree. Catch your right ankle with your right hand. Pull your right foot to the top of your inner left thigh. And you want to press your legs into one center line. The two legs into center, then ground down to a standing heel, lift up. Your crown. Anjali Mudra, Drishti Ujjayi, into the eternal quality, the essence, the truth, the being of this asana. Not about some goal in this asana. Be about the possibility of being fully present, awake, empowered. Now here in the asana is a place to come from and act from. Not going for some goal that doesn't now exist. Come from what you're a yes for, and that will expand. Lace your fingers, extend your arms up, squeeze your elbows in toward each other. Your two legs squeezing into each other. The pit of the lower belly, the pit of your belly pulling in toward your spine. Ground down, grow taller. Often you hear, typically you hear, it's probably happened to many of you, whether you know this or not. Typically, after a year, first year or two of yoga practice, people typically gain an inch, sometimes 2 inches in height. As things get decompressed. But partly that comes out of the work of doing the conscious, intended extending and decompressing. So you can't just kind of hang out and plop into the pose and hang. You got to do some work. Integration to center and core, center of core, grounding, extending, expanding. And then samasthitihi, yogi. Drishti to a point, please. Good. Vrikshasana tree. Other side. Catch your left ankle. Bring the bottom of your left foot to the top inner right thigh. Press your two legs into one. Bring your pelvis to neutral. Holding your water, the pelvic bowl neutral. Anjali Mudra. Drishti. Ujjayi. Bandhas. Tapas, inner vinyasa, lace your fingers extending. Samasthitihi. Breathe out. Integration, core to floor, floor to core. Look up, reach up, breathe in. Bow, exhale. Halfway lift, inhale. Chaturanga, low plank. Upward dog, downward dog. Right leg steps forward, warrior one. Go. Warrior two, flow. Trikonasana, triangle. So you'll straighten your front leg. You could use a block if you like to the outer side of the front leg. 3 points at the floor, 2 feet in your lower hand. You could lift the floor by using the block, but not holding the shin, yeah? Everyone, give yourself another foot, like another 12 inches or so between your feet. Just take your feet further away, wider, longer, apart. Mm-hmm. And you give yourself, I do even more, like bring your foot, this one back here. Even more, more and more. Mm-hmm. Try that. Scoop your tail, open your heart, Uddiyana. Contraction gives expansion. Bring something new, something kind of new here. Plug the floor down, pull up to core, belly, pit of your belly, pelvic floor. Open your chest. I don't know, do something different. Will you take your eyes somewhere new, up on the ceiling or something? It just, a lot of you look so, it looks static. Yeah, just bring it, make it more dynamic or something. A little more water element, fire element, space element. Okay, nice. What do you do now? Come up to standing. Mm-hmm. Turn your feet to 12 o'clock. Keep them wide. So you'll face the lateral left wall. Root down with your legs and lift up with your eyes and chest. Bow forward, exhale. Take a peek at your feet and just bring them to 12 o'clock. A lot of you, your feet, bring them on 12 o'clock. Just check it. Mm-hmm. It's all good now. Shake your head yes, no. Yes and no. Just let the blood drain down to your brain. Give your brain a flush, a fresh breath. Aerated blood, breathe. Let go, let go, give up. In this moment, there's an opportunity. If there's something in your way, just let it go. On the in-breath, let. The out-breath, it goes. In breath, you allow, you give. The out breath, it goes out, goes up and out. Giving up what's not you, giving up what's not in service of the true you. And then you'll catch your hips, take a deep breath out, root down, rise up from your legs. Exhale here. On your inhalation, take your arms out laterally. Exhale, reverse namaskara, hands between your shoulder blades. Now open your right leg and foot to face the front of the room, parsvottanasana. So you'll turn in, you'll center your hips to face the front of the room, yeah? You'll shorten your stance a bit. Now center up, pull your right hip back, left hip forward. Now activate from your legs to the floor, press down, lift your heart up, look up. Open your throat up, breathe in, and then bow forward over your front leg. Lift halfway up, twisting triangle. You bring your left hand down. Block is good here, good tool. Under the left hand, right arm to the sky. Parivrita Trikonasana. Full expression, inhale, chaturanga, vinyasa, up dog, down dog, left leg steps, warrior one, warrior two, trikonasana, straighten your legs, triangle, left arm down, right arm up. Give yourself another foot or more between your feet. Go long at your base between your feet, go longer. Then explore what's available from right here. New, dynamic, fluid, expressive, not stagnant, not stale, not stuck. You want to adjust the earth of your body to center in such a way that then there's space, there's flow to dynamically express out. Sthira Sukha Asanam. Full expression. Do something fun. Play. Something just unique to this moment. And then come on up. Catch your hips. Turn your feet into 12 o'clock. Root down, rise up, inhale, look up, and bow. Interlace your fingers at your lower back. Plug your shoulders into your back, then wrap your arms forward. Catch your big toes with your peace fingers and lift halfway up. Give your neighbor a wake up. And bow forward. Take a deep breath out, catch your hips, the four corners of your feet at the floor, root and rise up. Take your arms out laterally. Inhale. Reverse namaskara. Exhale. Again, open the left foot and leg to the front of the room. Shorten your stance. Step in a bit. Yeah, turn your hips. Root down. Lift up. Inhale. Yogi bow. Exhale. Breathe out from the floor, from your feet to the floor, pull up to core and lift halfway up, twisting triangle, right hand down, left arm to the gods and goddesses, the spine lengthening, horizontal line, front to back, want your tailbone shifting so your lumbar spine's moving toward your belly. Pull the pit of your belly toward your spine. Take the contraction at core and to a big expansion. Do your heart, your upper back area, expanding, spinning, rinsing. Rinse out the dirty rag internally. Rinse out. A lot of you walked in with a lot of toxicity. And I don't even know you. But it's level one, I get to tell you that, the truth. Some of you have lost the light in your eyes. What's that about? Wasn't always like that. What's that all about? Get curious. Okay, good, good. Vinyasa, cleanse it all out. Cleanse the palate. Do a nice vinyasa. And a nice sigh at the end. Ha, ha. Holy moly, asana. You are in for something. You're up to something this week. Ho, ho. Holy moly, you have no idea. It's good. I'll just say that. This week will be remarkable. A markable moment in your life. On the map of your life, God put you right here. This is like a marking point. Not that anything in the past says anything wrong about it or with it, but it's just you're here for some kind of new opening, some kind of new beginning, some kind of new view of life. That's available here this week. I'm not going to do that to you. You'll do that to you. We'll just provide the tools. We will provide the tools and the commitment that you have that kind of shift for yourself, the shift that you came here for yourself, whatever that shift is. Maybe it's many shifts, and I surmise there's one big shift at the center of it all that will allow for new shifts in practical ways. Okay, what now? Let's see. You're in down dog? Come to high plank, please. Inhale. Low plank. High plank. Low plank. High plank. Low plank. High plank, low plank, high plank and hold. People that don't like doing these, you know what they say about it? I've heard it over the years. They say, this isn't yoga. And I started noticing anything they don't like isn't yoga. Did you see Karate Kid? Remember when the kid kept, the more recent one, Jackie Chan, and, what's his name? Will Smith's son? Yeah, Jaden Smith kept dropping his, you know, after he kept dropping the code, hang it up, drop it, hang it up. And he's like, this isn't Kung Fu. He said to Jackie Chan, he's like, this isn't Kung Fu. This is stupid. When are you going to teach me Kung Fu? And Jackie Chan looked at him and said, everything is Kung Fu. Yeah, consider that everything is yoga. Everything, everywhere, all of the time, in every moment, even this pose. Lower slowly together, 99, 98, 97. Okay, just kidding, lie down. The type A's are like, I can do this. And the type B's, you all just slam to the floor, like, I'm done, I quit. By the way, type A's, we expect more of you this week. We expect more out of you, type A's. Less B's, we expect less. Just how it is in the world. Mm-hmm. Okay, bend your knees, catch your feet. And you'll take your bow asana, floor bow, dhanurasana. You'll rise up. Have you take this, choose to take this. Bring drishti, a point, ujjayi breath, move breath. Bandhas, pit of you, pull your belly button up toward your spine off the floor. Tighten the bow from arms, legs, hands, feet. Tightening the bow, pull into center more. Rise higher, inhale. Roll to your right side. Quick before your neighbor gets away. This week, so a lot of you haven't worked with me as a teacher before, and I don't care if you do a pose messy, I don't care if you fail in the pose or what have you, but I do want you to be in action, like in some kind of dance, some kind of interaction with the pose in your own way, that you're in some kind of exploration, some kind of dance, some. When you notice you're not, you just keep bringing yourself back. Doesn't have to be pretty, it could be, but you're in the dance. You're staying in on the mat. Okay, then you'll come up to center on the inhalation. Rise up, 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 and then the other side. Go over to the left side, please. Good work. Come back to center. Rise up, inhale. Big rise, rise high, higher, and then come down slow. Upward facing dog. Up dog. Downward facing dog. You did so good tonight, you earned a song. That's how level one goes. You work hard and well, we throw you a song. Throw you a sardine in the form of a song. Okay, now let's see. Right leg steps forward. And you'll bring your back knee down to the mat. Bring your hands to your hips, chest over your hips. Take half camel or Ustrasana. So you'll take your left hand to your back foot. You want to tighten your legs. Pull your feet, legs up into center. Uddiyana. Catch the foot, reach back, go.
Anjaninan Dana.
Come up, downward dog.
Namo, namo.
Step your left leg forward, half camel again, half camel. Well, not again, it's all new on this side, yeah? Half camel, go, right hand to the right side. Right foot, reach.
Namo, namo. Namo. Namo.
Come up, downward dog.
Namo.
Walk your feet up your mat. Bring your knees down to the top of your mat. Feet at hip width for full camel. Ustrasana. Squeeze your legs. Scoop your tailbone. Shoulders into your back. Catch your feet. Shins down. Heart rising. Breathing. Drishti.
Jaya Ram, Jaya Hanuman. Jaya Ram, Jaya Hanuman.
Come up on your feet and then press your hands to the mat.
Jaya Ram,
lift your feet, cross your ankles, roll over your feet onto your back, come onto your feet to Setu Bandhasana, bridge pose, hips up. You could stay here and bridge Dhanurasana, or you could take wheel pose. Urdhva Dhanurasana, hands alongside your head, come to the crown, integration, and rise up. Wheel one, two, three, four, root to rise, tuck your chin, come down slow. Take a deep breath in on the floor and take a big sigh. And then again, bridge, wheel pose. Ready, set, and go up. Wheel.
One,
two, three, four. To rise and five down slow. Big breath in and sigh. And again, hips up, ridge, wheel, hands alongside your head, come to the crown, integration, root, and rise high. One, two, three, four, five, come down. Again, bridge, hips go up, hands alongside your head, wheel set up, root down and rise up the wheel. One, two, three, four, five, come down. Last two. Reset, hips up. Hands alongside your head, come to the crown. Ready, set, root, and rise up the wheel. One, two, three, four, and five. Fifth chin, come down. Okay, last wheel, last one. Make it a powerful one for yourself. Lift your hips, bridge, reset, and take it up. One, two, three, four.
Yeah, Hanuman, go side.
and by and down. Shavasana, stretch your leg up. Squeeze your knees into your chest. Happy dead bug pose. Straighten your legs out laterally into your neighbors as much as possible. Straighten your legs, tailbone to the earth. Breathing. If you're not quite touching your neighbors, rock left to right until you touch them. Side. Okay, knees together, your chest, rock and roll, rock up and back. Navasana, boat pose. Lobo. Lobo. Low. High. Cross your ankles to down dog. Down dog. Bring your right foot to the outside of your left hand. Right foot to the outside of your left hand. Bring your right knee to your right wrist for half pigeon. Back leg down. Keep your back toes tucked. Bring your forearms to the mat. Nope, your upper back. Ujjayi, Rishi, Bandha. Bend your back leg. Catch your back foot with your right hand. Come onto your left forearm. Squeeze your legs, both legs into the center. Open your chest, look up, open your throat. And come to center. Now, excuse me, take your back leg and stack it over your front leg. So double pigeon. Yeah, and then push your hands down with your hips up and swing your hips back. Or you pull your sit muscles back manually. And then you could bow forward. You could walk over to the left side or right side, wherever you like. Find something here that has value, that has purpose. There's something to be awakened, something to be empowered, something to be, some potential to be discovered, something to be released, or being an open inquiry in your body, dynamic, fluid. Sitting up, twisting. So you'll take your bottom foot in toward your hip. The upper foot flat. Take your right arm over your upper thigh, left hand behind you. Then feet, legs, pull up into core. Press your arms down, shoulders back, look over your left shoulder, breathing. Reverse your twist. Upper body, open face. Look forward. Janusirsasana. You'll take your left upper leg straight out. An angle, pull your right foot in. Touch your front foot, left foot, however you like. And down. Good. Come up to center. And flatten your right foot. Take your left ankle over your right thigh. Press your arms down. Lift your hips up. Head back. Open your throat. Come down. Navasana. Go close. Lova. Hypo. Low. You want to go low, so I want low. High? He wants to go high, go high. Oh, higher. Go higher. Oh, higher. And low. And high. Cross your ankles, downward dog. Bring your left foot to the outside of your right hand. Left foot to the outside of your right hand. Bring your left knee to your left wrist for half pigeon. Back knee down, back toes tucked. Bring your forearms down. Drishti Ujjayi. Bandhas. Tapasya, tapas, vinyasa. The inner flow, the inner movement, the dynamic, forever moving, changing. Quality of the body, you're going with that. In a dance with that. The mind gets static, stuck. Disassociated from the nature, the true nature of the body. So let go of mind here. Come into being here. Being with and in your body's experience. Like really, not as a concept, but like really feel what you feel, experience what you experience, be and let be. Like for real, as in reality of experience. Okay, catch your back foot with your opposite arm, however you want to do that. Squeeze it all in, periphery, the core, from core expand out. Have fun. Oh, feels so good. Okay, good work. Come to center, neutral, and then take your back leg and stack it over your front leg. Press your arms down and swing your hips back, or manually you could pull your sit muscles back, and then you come, you could stay upward, you come forward, get over sideward. Just find some place that's calling for attention, acknowledgement, something that wants to awaken, something in you or in this part of your body's experience of this pose that could be empowered or released or discovered some potential. Potencia. Just one observation I'll say about what I notice in the room. A lot of you have one way of doing each pose. Like you have, you know the pose, and you do that pose one way, and it looks like you do it that way every time you do it. And it's just a kind of good place to start looking at your automaticity. Okay, good. Is that almost even? What comes next? Twist? Twist, what comes next? Twist? Okay, you sure? Not quite. Take a twist. Open face, reverse your twist. Good, look forward. What comes next? This is a test. Okay, good. Janu Sirsasan. Catch your foot. And bow. Come up. What comes next? Oh, yeah. Ardha. What's this called? Half tabletop. Left foot flat, right leg crosses the left leg. And then come up. You want to take your hips all the way up to neutral. Lift your tailbone. Open your throat. Good, come down. Straighten both legs forward. Paschim Uttanasana. Pull your sit muscles back a little, I don't know, or out, whatever you want, or don't do that. Catch your feet. Some teachers say that's wrong, don't ever do that. Others say you must always do that. So I don't know, do what your teacher, inner teacher says to do. Halfway, bow forward all the way. A lot of you, another quick observation, you don't trust yourself. It's like written all over your body, like a blinking neon light. I don't trust myself. And you're looking for some shiny object on the outside to tell you what to do, because you don't trust you. So just an observation. And maybe I'm not talking if you got a little insulted by what I said, then I'm definitely talking to you, right? If what I said kind of went over your head, then yeah, it probably wasn't meant for you. If you got a little triggered there, then, what's that about? Only someone who doesn't trust themselves would get upset when someone says you don't trust yourself. Someone said, Baron, you don't trust yourself. I go, who, me? Like, oh. Or if I was being defensive, like, what do you mean I don't trust myself? You're talking to me? Okay, really good. Paschimottanasana. No. Purvottanasana. No, what's it called? Purvo, yeah? It's Purvo, yeah? My friend from Kenya, what comes next? What's Sanskrit? Not fish. Yeah, the full, whatever it's called, who cares? Just do the thing. So you'll keep your legs straight, point your toes. You could do tabletop with your knees bent like that. It's fine, heels on your knees. Otherwise, legs straight, lift your hips. You want you to push your toe tips to the floor. Hips up, head back. Parvottanasana. Hips all the way up, sir. Yeah. Sir, hips up and tongue in your mouth. Okay, come down slow. Okay, real quick, you'll take an inversion of your choice. Do, let's say, do Viparita Karani, block under your pelvis, or shoulder stand. Do one of those two. How about that? Viparita Karani, waterfall pose, or the shoulder stand. Shavasana, Shavasana. We all know about being somewhere and not really being here. In our heads, some in some other sphere, some other world, and not here. Shavasana is the practice of being right here. Right here. Being right here is an opportunity for yourself. A gift that only you can gift you. The opportunity, the gift of being in the experience of fully alive, awake to life, right here. So be a yes for being awake, fully awake, right here. Relaxed, at ease. Relaxed and alert. Feeling what you're feeling. Hearing what you're hearing. Being. Giving up all expectations, worries, give up all goals. Shavasana isn't about going somewhere, getting somewhere. Getting right here, being here. There's nothing to do here. Nothing to think here. Be here as a gift. rolling to your right side into a fetal position. Just curling up, bringing your head toward your legs and your legs toward your chest. And from the same side, press down and come up to a seated position with your eyes closed. Creating your seat here, your asana here, your body here as an outer measure of an inner reality, an inner higher intentionality. Yeah, create your body, your form of this asana as a measure, an outer measure of an inner intention, a higher intention, a higher reality, the reality that you are a yes for in this moment. Bring your hands to Anjali Mudra at your chest center. We'll take three ohms. Bring your thumbs to your forehead center and touch in, tap in to the ground of your being, to the essence of who you are. Take a deep, deep breath in. Namaste. Namaste. Good work.